gentlemen, good evening. Welcome to this service of commemoration. Before I explain the order of events, can I respectfully remind you all to abide by the COVID-19 guidelines of keeping 2 meters apart and to wear face coverings where appropriate. On a health and safety matter, please be extra careful if you are standing near the edge of the river. The lifeboat is there ready for you if you do fall in. At this time, I would ask you all to light your candles or your other lights and keep them lit throughout the service. At exactly 18:14, I will ring my bell to signal a 2 minute period of silence to reflect on the crew of Joanna C. Meanwhile, would you please give your attention to Councillor Graham Webb, the Mayor of Dartmouth, who would like to address you.
Honoured guests, ladies and gentlemen, as Mayor of Dartmouth, I am saddened but extremely heartened that we can all gather here together this night with our friends from over the water in Kingswear. We stand proudly in solidarity with each other to remember the young and valuable lives of Adam Harper and Robert Morley, who were lost to us in the waters off the coast of East Sussex. We also give grateful thanks to their skipper, Dave Bickerstaff, who was miraculously rescued from the waters on that morning. The weather was dreadful when they set sail, but sail they did, on the familiar deck of the Joanna C, to carry out the job they knew best and loved. It started as an ordinary scalloping trip, but ended in tragedy during the early hours of the 21st of November. The final trip of the Joanna C ended in selfless heroism, a true example of man risking his life for his fellow crewmen. To quote, "Greater love has no man than this, that a man lay down his life for his friends." Robert Morley struggled with everything the sea could throw at him, and his skipper, Dave Bickerstaff, bravely tried to save his fellow crewmen. None of us here this evening will ever know what fear they must have felt and endured during those fatal few minutes. Our heartfelt thoughts go out to their families and to Dave, who, thank the Lord, was spared. We wish you a speedy recovery from your ordeal. Thinking of all this today, I recall a simple yet eloquent prayer for sailors who set off to sea. Keep us, our God, for your ocean is wide and our boat is small. And so it was with the Joanna C. Although she was a 45-foot scalloping vessel, in the end, the ocean and the weather were too great a challenge for her. A freak wave turned her over and tragically she sank, taking young Adam Harper with her. We sincerely hope there is some small relief for his family in that Adam has now been recovered and returned to them. This means they can now make arrangements for his final journey, surrounded by his loving family and friends. Robert Morley is yet to be yielded up by the sea. We pray it will not be too long before he too may return to his own. It is 2 weeks ago to the day at 14 minutes past 6 o'clock in the morning that the Joanna C was lost to the depths. We stand here now shoulder to shoulder, both in Dartmouth and Kingswear. Let us now give ourselves some time to think about these brave men who risked and lost their lives on this day pursuing their traditional livelihoods. We remain forever grateful to those men and women that are prepared for our sakes to put themselves at risk each time they venture out. Fishing is a dangerous occupation. We must never underestimate what they must face each time they leave the safety of harbour. Brixham, the people of Kingswear and Dartmouth want you to know that we stand with you today. We gather together here by the River Dart and say thank you for sending your fishermen, sons and daughters to sea for all our sakes. God protect them. Adam and Robert, rest in peace and rise again in glory. Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, pray silence for prayers led by the Reverend Dr. Andrew Langley and Reverend Bob Boyle.
As we remember before God, Adam and Robert, we give thanks for the safe rescue of Dave. Thank you, Father, for your mercy, which is beyond our knowledge, for your grace, which is as limitless as your power, for your love, which is vaster than the deep, for the hope in Christ, which keeps us going onward through all difficulties and loss, for the opportunity of good, for every incentive we have to serve you, and for the assurance of your constant care. Grant, O Lord, to all who are bearing the pain of grief and bereavement, your spirit of healing, your spirit of life, your spirit of peace and hope, of courage and endurance. Comfort them in their time of need and in their loneliness. Cast out from them the spirit of anxiety and fear. Grant them perfect confidence and trust in you, that in your light they may see light, for your name's sake. Amen. Amen.
We pray for Adam and Robert. Almighty and eternal God, from whose love in Christ we cannot be parted, either by death or life, hear our prayers and our thanksgivings for Adam and Robert, whom we remember this day. Fulfill in them the purpose of your love and bring us all with them to your eternal joy, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. In giving thanks for the safe rescue of Dave, we pray for the emergency services, the Coast Guard and RNLI, and for the work of the Fisherman's Mission. Merciful Father, all things in heaven and earth are held within your loving care. Look with favour upon the RNLI, the Coast Guard and emergency services. Protect and bless the crews and staff and all who risk their own safety to bring help to others, and for those who continue to offer support to those in need. We ask this through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. We say a prayer for all seafarers. Eternal Lord God, ruler of earth and sky, receive into your protection all who go down to the sea in ships and work upon the waters. Preserve them in body and soul. Prosper their labours with success. In times of danger, be their help and defence, and bring them safely into port, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
And so we join our prayers together using the words our Saviour taught us. Our Father, which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, in earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those
and lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen.
Ladies and gentlemen, there is still a few minutes to go, 3 minutes to go before the 2 minute silence. I will ring my bell to commence the 2 minute silence, and the end will be marked by the solitary church bells of St. Saviour's and St. Thomas. And this will be followed by an a cappella version of Shoals of Herring, sung by Mike Dyer of Dartmouth's very own Naughty Boys. Perhaps this is a good time for people to turn their phones off during the 2 minute silence. We're about a minute away from the silence. Thank you. Okay, ladies and gentlemen. Mike, would you like to come forward?
Oh, it was a fine and a pleasant day. Out of Yarmouth Harbour I was faring, as a cabin boy on a sailing lugger, for to fish the bonny shoals of herring. Oh, the work was hard, and the hours were long, and the tradesman surely took some bearing. There was little kindness, and the kicks were many, as we're following the shoals of herring. Well, we fished the swarf and a broken bank. I was cook and I'd a quarter sharing. I used to sleep standing on me feet, and I'd dream about the shoals of herring. Well, we left the home ground in the month of June, and for canny shields we soon were bearing, with 100 cran of the silver darlings that we'd taken from the shoals of herring. Now you're on deck, you're a fisherman, you can swear and hae a manly bearing. Take a turn on watch with the other fellows, as we're following the shoals of herring. Well, I earned me keep and I paid me way, and I earned the gear that I was wearing. Sailed 1,000,000 miles, caught 10,000,000 fishes, as we're following the shoals of herring. Through the stormy seas and the living gales, just to earn our daily bread we're daring. From the Dover Straits to the Faroe Islands, as we're following the shoals of herring. With our nets and our gear we're faring on a wild and wasteful ocean. It's out there on the deep that we harvest our bread, as we hunt the bonny shoals of herring.
May Christ the Good Shepherd enfold you with love, fill you with peace, and lead you in hope to the end of your days. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be with you now and remain with you always. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Including all their families, loved ones, friends.